back with the man who knows everything, David Bender.
Where is that guy?
Hey, buddy.
I wish I knew more about this story, Mike, because we've been hearing about it for years, and Jeremy Scahill, who literally wrote the book on Blackwater, has a new article out in The Nation talking about how the founder of Blackwater, Eric Prince, that secretive guy, we know the stories, we've heard about him for years. Well,
Eric
finally,
Prick, or is it Prick or Prince?
Prince. It depends on how you want to pronounce it. If it's a silent N, yes, it would be Prick. Uh-huh. But Eric Prince, according to new allegations, and these were sworn statements filed in federal court in Virginia, two men claim that Eric Prince, the owner of Blackwater, may have murdered or facilitated the murder of individuals who were cooperating with federal authorities investigating the company. The former employee also alleges that Prince, quote, views himself as a Christian crusader tasked with eliminating Muslims and the Islamic faith from the globe, and that Prince's companies, and I'm quoting here, this is, you know, this
Knights
isn't
of Malta,
me.
Man.
This isn't me. This is in sworn statements in a federal court. If Eric Prince, or however he says his name, wants to sue them. According to them, that Prince's companies encouraged and rewarded the destruction of Iraqi life.
No, hey, Eric, sue me. Nothing would make me happier than to be able to take your friggin' deposition.
Well,
sue me.
And you know what? It looks like finally some of this stuff about Blackwater, the secretive stuff, and we're starting to see, Mike, and it's all happening at the same time. It's really interesting. These crazed Christian fundamentalists, people like Eric Prince Blackwater, the veil is being pulled back. And we're seeing
What do the affidavits, tell me some of the things, what do the affidavits say? These are sworn affidavits, John Doe affidavits. They're afraid that they're going to be killed. Says that
they say that Blackwater was smuggling weapons into Iraq. Prince turned a profit by transporting illegal or unlawful weapons into the country on his private planes. They charge that Prince and other Blackwater executives destroyed incriminating videos, emails, and other documents, and have intentionally deceived the U.S. State Department.
Well, do they make allegations of money laundering?
Well, you know, this is an extensive
or tax evasion.
You know, this is going through. Both individuals allege that Prince and Blackwater deployed individuals to Iraq who were not properly vetted and cleared by the State Department. They ignored pleas from employees who sought to stop the unnecessary killing of innocent Iraqis. This is incredible stuff. All the stuff, by
and
the way.
And this is coming from their own employees.
That's right.
My understanding, my memory of this story is that these employees have already been threatened. These employees say that Prince has already murdered other employees.
That's what they're alleging. And yes, indeed, they're also saying that there was money laundering from one company, Blackwater, to another, Greystone.
And this was reported in The Nation, Jeremy Scahill.
Jeremy Scahill, who wrote the book on this.
And he says these affidavits are actual affidavits.
That's right.
Hey, as a matter of fact, Blackwater, if you're listening, let's see, they're called not Black. They had to change their name in order to do business in, I forgot what they call them.
But if Eric
Z,
Prince is,
it's like Prince. Or,
that's right. Yeah, it's just got a letter now. It's a symbol. But if Eric Prince is listening, what do you want to say to him, Mike?
Well, I want to say, come on the air. Let's ask you. But this is bad. These affidavits are incredible. And if they're wrong, come on the air, Mr.
You know
Eric
who
Prince.
You know. Let's get talk about you know who we should get on the air is Dennis Kucinich, because he's pursuing this. He
let's
says,
do it, Scott. Set up Dennis Kucinich.
Dennis Kucinich says, Congressman Dennis Kucinich, quote here: if these allegations are true, Blackwater has been a criminal enterprise defrauding taxpayers and murdering innocent civilians.
All right. What else you got out there? That's a great story.
You know, that I got to tell you
is kind of hard to beat.
And the only thing I want to say, and I think, you know, it connects up the dots here. I started to say a second ago that what we've been seeing, and I just interviewed last week here on the program, the author of the book on the family and the whole issue of these secret conservative Christian cults, these fundamentalists, mm-hmm. like Blackwater as a corporation, like the family and the C Street House in Washington, these groups that go back, and in the case of the family, go back 70 years. Mm-hmm. These people who accrue power in the name of Christ and say that this is God's will for them to have power.
Prince thinks he's one of the Knights of the Templar, you know, Knights of Malta.
Knights of Malta. And here's what's interesting. You know, talk about the world turned on its head. And by the world, I mean literally the publication, The World, which is the Christian conservative publication, has finally this past week, Mike, has gone after the family and is saying, you know what, here's the problem. These people think they are the church, and they're not. And they
investigations underway with that, right?
That's right. Absolutely, investigations underway. When you are criticized, think about this. When you're criticized by Chuck Colson, who's criticizing the family in C Street, is saying, hey, this is not really what Christianity is about. When you have somehow gone afoul of Chuck Colson, you know you have strayed from the word.
You have fallen to the bottom.
That is it.
David Bender, maybe you think Eric Prince will give us a call and come on the air and answer these affidavits? These aren't our words. These are affidavits that have been sworn against him.
Do me a favor. Please don't hold your breath. Okay. I like you the way you are.
All right, David Bender, thanks for joining me. Another fun route through the world of news.
Always a pleasure, Mike.